Hello. This is today we're going to talk about indirect anti-globulin test or indirect Coombs and antibody screening. Now, last week we talked about anti-globulin test in general, and we talked about the direct anti-globulin test or the direct hemoglobin direct Coombs test. Sorry. Now, the direct and just to refresh your memory, direct anti-globulin test is to test for sensitized red blood cells that takes place in vivo. So we take the cells immediately, we wash it, we see if it is these cells has these RBCs has been coated with immune antibodies. So all we have to do, we added the anti-human globulin. Now the indirect anti-globulin test, indirect anti-globulin test is to test for the cells that has been sensitized in vitro, So we take the cells, they are not sensitized. During the testing, we add antibody, and they could be sensitized, and we check if they are sensitized or not. So what do we use these anti-globulin tests? Actually, we already used it twice. It's more indirect Coombs test. We used it for when we did RH phenotyping. Remember DEU? We use it too for, we're going to be used for what's called antibody screening. We used it one more time when we did cross matching. Now, remember when we did the cross matching and how we did the sensitizing in vitro? We took a patient plasma and we took the donor's RBC. We wanted to know for cross matching, just to refresh your memory, if there is any antibody in the patient's plasma against one of those antigens on the donor's RBCs. I'm talking about unexpected antibody, not anti-A or anti-B. Those are expected, those we know about it. Now, unexpected are called alloantibodies. So what we do is, these RBCs, they have antigen, as we know, and we don't know if there is antibody against one of those antigens. So, if there is antibody here against one of those antigens, those RBC will be looking like this. These antibody antigen, of course, this antibody, if there is such antibody, alloantibody, against one of those antigens, that will be. But since the antibody is usually IgG, it's a small antibody, usually causes cell sensitization in sensitized cells, but does not agglutinate the cells. If there is no antibody, the cells will look like this. there's no antibody against those antigen. No antibody, these are the cells, and these, and the, there's no, no, see, the cell looks like this, there's no antibody. But these won't agglutinate, and these won't agglutinate. So when we get negative after we spinning, the cells could be sensitized like this, or could be like this, there's nothing. The way we solve the problem is only with anti-human globulin. To add anti-human globulin, this is how we, how Mr. Coombs solved the problem. He came up with the anti-human globulin. We add anti-human globulin. If the cells already sensitized and positive, the cells will look like this. These anti-human will cross, and we have agglutination. If it is negative, there is no antibody here, the anti-human globulin will not agglutinate these cells. So after adding anti-human globulin, if it's a positive, mean the patient has allo antibody. If it's negative, the patient does not have any allo antibody. Now, notice, originally, we took the RBCs and added the patient plasma. Now, if the patient plasma has antibody, the cells is sensitized. Where the cells is sensitized? In the test tube. This is called indirect anti-human globulin test. The same thing we did with Rh phenotypic when we get a D negative. D negative or no agglutination in D, and I said we don't consider it negative until we make sure there is no D variant. It's called a DU or weak D. We have to go into anti-human globulin. This is called indirect antibody test or indirect Coombs test. Now, the new things is, which is the antibody screening. Antibody screening. Now, when we do cross match, if the cross match is negative, is what? Negative, that means in this particular patient plasma, there is no antibody against any of the antigens in this particular donor. But antibody screenings, yeah, here, it doesn't mean this patient does not have alloantibody against other donors' cells. See, when you do cross-match, it's specific for this donor cells. Now, if RBCs with the cross-matching with this patient's plasma is negative, it doesn't mean this guy does not have alloantibody against other donors, other cells. Yani, is the A1, A positive 1, and A positive donor recipient. If we did the cross match and turn on negative, so we're going to transfuse this to this. But if we got another patient, A plus, doesn't mean it's a cross match, and with this patient, we can be transfused with any A positive. No, this is particular for this donor. If we need to retransfuse this guy, need to transfuse with A positive from another donor, we have to do cross-matching. Now, antibody screening shows whether in the plasma of this patient there is no allo antibodies. If there is antibody screening, if we did antibody screening for the plasma of certain patient, if it's negative, we make sure, we are sure that no alloantibodies, or at least what's called significant or significant alloantibodies. What's significant alloantibody? Not every antibody, as I told you, can cause hemolysis to the cells, cells destruction. Some antibody exists against certain antigen on RBC, but they are harmless. They don't cause any problem. They don't cause hemolytic disease and red blood destruction, red blood cell destruction. These are insignificant. Only when we're looking for those antibody, if exist against certain antigen on our cells, they bind to our cells and cause the destruction of their cells and an hemolytic disease. These called significant alloantibodies. So, if we have serum here, and we want to know whether there is a significant, any significant antibody here. In another word, antibody that if we add RBCs here that has antigen against this antibody, this RBC is not gonna survive. We do what's called antibody screening. So you have going to memorize what significant antibodies that if exist, can bind its specific antigen and causes RBC destruction and hemolytic disease. Because our antibodies are not significant there, but they don't cause hemolysis or RBC destruction. These are, we have a patient serum. Now, the way we do it, we bring the patient serum and we bring commercially available all cells, usually three tubes of all cells from three different people. We buy it, tube one, it has O cells. Tube two, it has O cells. And tube three has O cells from the three different donors. These are commercially available by it. These cells are all O, are all what? O. But these cells contains antigens, contain phenotyped. Phenotyped that contains all significant antigens, all the significant antigens. Now, maybe this cell has a big D, big C, small E. This cell doesn't have big E. This cell should have big E. And what's missing from here, it could be there here. But the combination of the antigen on these three different cells have all the significant antigen. Now, we talked about significant antibodies. Now we're talking about significant what? Antigen. يعني, antigen if exists, and it has, and we have antibody against this antigen, when antibody bind to this antigen, cause the destruction of the red blood cells. So this is what's called significant antigen. Now, the significant antigens on these RBCs are, all these cells are only phenotyped. They should have, these are the significant antigen. I'm gonna write it down here, it's in your book, in your manual, big C, big D, big E, small c, small e, big M, big N, big S, P, L, E, A, L, E, B, K. These are antigens. Small k, F, Y, A, J, K, A, and J, K, B. I'm sure Dr. Wright most likely have told you about all these antigens on the RBCs. These antigens, these here, are called significant antigens. Significant what? Antigens. The reason it's called significant antigen, because assuming if we have RBC that has, let's say, big S. This is a, why is it significant? Because if the plasma of the patient has anti-big S, and the donor cells has big S, and happen the plasma of the patient has an antibody, is more anti-big S. If this guy is transfused with the RBC of this guy, the RBC here, what happened to this RBC? The anti-S is gonna bind to the big S and cause the destruction. The anti-S is called a significant antigen, significant antibody, and the big S here, since it's called a significant antigen. Now, doesn't have to, these O, they don't have, this O doesn't have to have all these antigens. It has some of them. And these have some of them. And these have some of these. But all these antigens, the combination of this and these antigen here, they should have all these. So, what's antibody screening? It's very simple. Let's take, this is what's antibody screening, how it's done. It's exactly done like cross-matching. Cross-matching, قلنا شو بنجيب اللي شو السال اللي بنجيبه؟ Donor cells. Donor شو هي؟ Donor cells, patient plasma. But this is testing for the donor. Antibody screening, the cells, here O1, O2, and O3. يعني three different tests. ناخذ مثلا ناخذ تيوب 1. نحط 2 drops of cells اللي هي O from tube 1 and 2 drops from patient serum. All right. This is tube 1. The same thing. Tube 2 and tube 3. The same thing. Tube 2 drops. Can you see? Huh?
Yes.
Let's see if this is better. Is it better? 2 drops of cells from tube 2 and 2 drops from patient serum. The same thing here, 2 drops, patient serum, and 2 drops from drops of cells from tube 3. Spin. Now we have is positive or negative. If it's positive, and positive here means there is some antibodies here against one of those significant antigens on these significant antigens on those cells. If it's negative, negative here and negative here. Yeah, no agglutination here and no agglutination here. Here, if there is no agglutination, shona, 2 possibilities. True negative or sensitized cells. All right, because it's IgG. All right? True negative mean that the patient's serum has no antibody against the antigens on these whole cells on tube 2. Here, what do we do in this case? To solve the problem, I'm not gonna go into details because we have done it so many times. We wash the cells and add anti-human globulin. Anti-human should wear globulin. Yani, we go into Coombs test. A positive mean there is antibody here, allo antibody. Negative means there is no allo antibody in tube 2 cells against often. There is no antibody in this patient against cells in these tubes. But every time we get anti-human globulin, negative anti-human globulin, we have to what? Add what? Check cells to make sure that anti-human globulin is working. So this is how we do the same thing for here. The same thing here and here and here. And if we find any positive, whether here or here or here, it means there is an antibody. There is what? An antibody in this patient's serum against one of those significant antigens. And this antibody must be identified, and patient should not be transfused with cells that has the antigen. So, I want to ask Nabila to come and focus on these pictures here. You see this one here? In page 54 in yours. These are 1, 2, 3. This is tube 1, tube 2, and tube 3. Now, these are the antigen. These are what? The antigen, the significant antigens. We have a plus and zero. What it means, the plus means the cells in tube one, the O cells in tube one has big D antigen and big sure C antigen, but does not have what? E antigen. It does not have small C antigen. It has small E antigen. Now, if you look at the tube here, it has D, does not have what? Big C. It has big E. See, this has small C. No one doesn't have it. So, the O and the cells in tube O doesn't have big D, but remember, the big D موجود هون. But it has this and this and so forth. So, look at the result we get. All right. When we put the patient blood, the patient serum with the cells from the first tube, we incubated at 37 degrees, it was negative. When we did anti-human globulin, it was negative. Check cell was positive. Yeah, and because anti-human globulin negative, check cell should be positive. This means negative. Negative means the patient does not have antibody against the antigen الموجودين هون. يعني does not have anti-D. Or does not have anti-sure big C. ليش؟ لأنه هيدا patient في the cells هون في big D big C. ولما حطينا مع السيرم طلع نيجاتيف. لو كان في anti-D big D بالسيرم كان طلع بوزيتيف. لكن نفس الشيء بالنسبة لل tube 2. Negative, negative, positive. هلا بالنسبة لتيوب 3 شو هو؟ تيوب 3 من نفس الشيء طلع. The first time when we spin it the first time after incubation negative. بس when we add into human globulin طلع شو هو؟ Positive. معناته the cell كانت sensitized. We did not run CCC or the check cells because it is a positive. We only get it when we're going to read the check cells of CCC when it is negative. بما انه عندنا انت human globulin positive with cell 3 اللي has this, اللي has this antigen and this antigen and this antigen and this antigen, يعني there is antibody against one of those antigen that's on. Which one? From, you have to go by the process of elimination, and Dr. Raed will explain it to you when it gets to when you get to talk about antibody screening. So, antibody screening, we use indirect Coombs test to check if there is a significant antibody in the patient's serum against any of those significant antigens. That's it.